Howdy and welcome to Let's Play IL-2 Storm of It with me, Nob, which will do a Russian campaign here. Take a look at our stats. We have 7 aircraft kills, we have 121 ground kills, we have 5903 points, we have 2 medals, and we lost 14 aircraft. That's a nice way of putting that we died 14 times. We finished 19 missions. Anyway, mission number 20, the hunt for the destroyer. 11th of August 1945, 4:40 in the morning. It's dawn, it's early, we are very cranky. The location is still Sukhaya Reka. Mission briefing: early on the 11th of August, we got our next orders. According to recon, a Japanese destroyer was seen leaving the Racine Harbor and going south at full speed. It was assumed that the warship was evacuating something important: equipment, personnel, or maybe even documents. The Japanese seemed to know that our amphibious operation was just days away, so the Japs are trying to leave here. Our fleet was unlikely to catch up to the destroyer, so the only way to sink it, while it was still in the Russian designated waters, was to send Sturmoviks on a skip bombing mission. So this shall be our first official skip bombing mission. Sink the enemy destroyer. Now before it was taking off, each plane will have 4 of the FAV-100. Bombs, altitude 600 meters. Our flying boat is monitoring the warship's movements, so far it continues sailing south through quadrant AF3. That's right here. So, the ship is IJN Yukikaze DD 1945. Whatever that means, that's the name of the destroyer. It's leaving this harbor. It went out this way, I guess. It's trying to head south, I guess. How do we find this thing? We go and we'll take off and we'll just head the vector 220 for a long while. Maybe vector 221. But hopefully we'll find it, because it's in the middle of the ocean here. It's very hard to navigate just by looking at the water. Especially in the morning. The morning mist is all over the ocean. The fog is over the water. It's a little bit hard to spot anything. So there will be 4 of us, 2 flights of 2. Each plane has 4 of the 100 kilogram bombs. And we drop them in pairs, so we have 2 shots. And the bombs are mounted just underneath our fuselage, so it won't be too hard to aim. Let's see, low level bombing, 5 second delay, fuse. Everything good to go. So in order to skip bomb, first of all, I don't think my 3 of my wingmen will skip bomb, because I don't think AI ever does skip bombing. But in order to do skip bombing, you can do it over the water or over the land. But you gotta make sure it's flat. You gotta fly low. You gotta fly as low as possible, but not too low, because if you look right here, I guess you can't read it with the map open. It says arming at 18 meters drop altitude. So we gotta fly low, but not any lower than 18 meters in altitude. Okay, external lights on, landing light on, internal light on. Flaps down, radiator open, throttle down, prop pitch up, fuel mixture up. There's no supercharger, hold down the wheel brakes, lock the tail wheel, start the engine. Alright, so there's the 4 of us. The morning mist, number 1, number 2, followed by number 5 and number 6. So there were 2 groups, para 1 and para 2. It's the rising sun behind us.
Clear to take off.
It's very early in the morning. Alright, our engine's on. Everything good to go. Start up the engine. Put the wheel brakes. Oh, you gotta use the wheel brakes to manage the pull. It has a hard right pull. It's a torque effect of this engine. Very powerful engine. Pulls very hard to the right, trying to speed up on the ground. So unlike the tail wheel, pitch back, we're up there. Rise up to 90 meters. Right, lower the fuel mixture to about 100%. Turn off the intermittent lights. Gotta trim the yaw a little bit to the left. This plane doesn't have the roll trim. It has an elevator trim and the yaw trim. I'm gonna lower the elevator trim down a bit. Alright. We're headed for vector 230 right now. We want to be heading vector 220. Which will raise up the flaps before we forget. Okay, that's about vector 220 right here. So we're gonna climb up to altitude 600. It'll be a long while until we reach our destination. We'll try to get up to the right altitude, and altitude 500 right now. Try to stay at vector 220. Or altitude 650 right now. So I'm gonna trim down my plane even further. And I'm gonna throttle down a bit. I'm gonna lower the fuel, not the fuel mixture, but the prop pitch and the radiator control. But we're gonna cruise on out there. Turn off the external light. And we have our rear gunner, Bob, in the backseat. Go with there. Anyway, we're gonna head vector 220. We're off course already. But it'll take us about 20 minutes to get there, so I'll be back after we get there. Alright, I believe we are nearby because PBY, that is the airplane, or the flying boat as they say, that is keeping an eye out on destroyer. We're headed vector 220 out to the 600. Two of my guys are to my right. My number two is behind me. I can only hope. Can't really see him. The visibility out of this airplane is very bad. Anyway, hopefully we can spot the destroyer, but it's hard to see anything because of the morning fog over the water. It's almost 5 a.m. That's the flags from the destroyer. He found us. I think he was right in front of us somewhere. Still hard to see anything. I see him. He's moving to the right, which is almost northward. It's turning to the right. So it's only the complete opposite of what our intel says. But that's how it goes. My guys are gonna drop their bombs. Hopefully, many of the bombs will hit it. I'm not too optimistic. Number 5, number 6, they dropped their bombs. One got really close. One got pretty close, but no. Number 2 is flying. Hopefully he can do some damage. So no one did any skip bombing, as we were supposed to. Now the ship is moving northward. It's turning. May still be turning. I'm gonna head this direction for a bit. I'm gonna turn around. And I'm gonna initiate my skip bombing. So in order to skip bomb, you gotta fly low. But you gotta fly above altitude 18 meters for our bombs to arm itself. I'm gonna turn around to vector 120 or so. Hopefully we can find the ship. And the other requirement for skip bombing is that you gotta fly fast. And this plane is no problem flying fast. So not to worry about that. I think the tracers are coming from that direction. Still don't see the ship, but I think the tracers were coming from this direction. full speed. I think I see it. I think I'm perpendicular to it. I gotta fly low, but not too low. I gotta fly perpendicular to the horizon. Give it a little lead. Bombs go. Fly away. Bombs are skipping. Landed on the side of the boat. Wait 5 seconds. Boom. Alright, that was a solid hit on the boat. But of course, just one pair of bombs is not enough to kill the destroyer. This mission is probably already a failure because I needed a couple of my planes, to hit the ship, their bombs. But I think they all failed. So even if I hit all four of my bombs to the exact same spot of the boat, I don't think we can sink the destroyer. So this mission is probably already a failure. It's not gonna stop us. Some skip on it. That's all those flaks. All that flak is trying to get to me. Alright, the ship is, I don't know, maybe vector 240 from me? I don't know, 210? Kind of lost track of it. I think it's this direction. Yeah, there it is. Lot of speed. Hopefully the ship hasn't turned, otherwise I may have to turn around and come from a different angle. It hasn't turned. I see it. Why not? Very dangerous. A little bit more of a skip bomb. Get out of here. Bombs are skipping. Landed the side of the boat. Port side. Bombs did not ignite. They did not detonate. So yeah, this mission is a failure. I don't know what went wrong with the bombs. It's possible that there were duds. Probably were duds because they looked good. They looked like they skipped the right, both of them. I was over altitude 18 meters, I believe. Everything went right. I think the bombs were duds. But even if they had hit the bomb, hit the destroyer, I don't think the destroyer would have been sunk. We did some damage to it. It's in our best interest to get out of here now. Our cannons and our guns will not do anything to the destroyer, no matter from which angle, how much I hit it. It's not enough firepower to kill the destroyer. I really needed one or two more planes to land their bombs on the destroyer, but they couldn't do it. I can't tell my guys to skip bomb. They'll just fly over and drop the bomb, and they're gonna think it's a static target. But the ship was moving at full speed, and it was turning at that. So yeah, they completely missed all 12 of the bombs. They all missed. Two of my bombs hit, and they detonated. They did damage. And my last pair of bombs, I believe they hit, but they didn't detonate. So something went wrong with the bombs. Anyway, I'm gonna get myself back home. It'll be another 20 minutes or so of flying. We'll cruise on out of here. I don't expect to see any enemy planes or anything hostile on the way. So I'll be back once we get home and watch the sunrise. Alright, we're coming on home. airbase should be right in front of us, but can't see shit because of the morning fog. Can request for runway lights, but I don't think they'll turn it on. This is the right area. Oh, there it is. Okay, it's right underneath us. They did turn on some lights for us, I guess. Burning some fire or something, I don't know. But let's see how we can find this shit. Right. The runway is vector 60. It's runway 6, that's basically what that means. I'm gonna try to hover on it, try to lose some altitude and speed. And hopefully land on the next pass. Some LAs are parked. So I guess those are lights for us? I don't know. Maybe they have beacons. But I don't think we use beacons in this airplane. So hopefully I can fly back to 240 for a while. Turn to vector 60 to our left. Hopefully we'll find it. A lot of altitude. Fly to vector 60. There it is. Hopefully we're all lined up. Full prop pitch, open radiator.
Первый, вам разрешена посадка. Следите за самолетами на полосе.
Really can't see anything. Just hoping it's in front of me somewhere. Forest in front of me. This doesn't sound right. Where is the airport? Oh, there it is. I see the four lights. Alright, let's do some flaps. Really hard to find. Thank goodness for those four lights. Gears down. Still don't see the runway, but I'm just gonna guess it's here. Park next to this LA to the left. We landed. We're parked. I don't know where my other guys are. Number 2 is out flying. Number 5 and number 6 are still out flying, I guess. some LA planes. The flying boat. UI. Here we are again. And that's it, we can't really get the enemies. There's no enemy airplanes. Well, that's good enough, I guess. I mean, if we had to, we really had to, well, someone else really had to hit the boat with their bombs. We did our part. I think we got 50 points for it. But we were able to do some damage to the ship. But even if my last pair of bombs had detonated at the exact same spot where the first pair had, that wouldn't have been enough to destroy the destroyer. Anyway, early in the afternoon on the 11th, I was ordered to report to the command post. I wondered what was so important. And the weather was non-flying. Yeah, it was pretty bad. And we usually didn't get our next day's orders until late night. The CO, commanding officer explained, during our strike against enemy's coastal installations and communication lines, far to the north, units of the 1st Red Banner Army continued their advance virtually without air support. So yeah, we were doing shit down here while other guys are going from the north. Their two pincers were converging on a Japanese citadel, the city of Mudanjiang, the final hurdle before their ultimate goal, Harbin. In only 2 days, moving across very difficult terrain, our units moved deep into enemy held territory, and were now within striking distance of the target, the city of Mudanjiang. Commanders on the ground now requested more assistance from the Air Force. I guess that would be us. They needed more strikes on the enemy defensive positions, warehouses, and transport columns. Those sound like a Sturmovik missions to me. The Pacific Fleet VVS considered our task complete. So we're done with the Sea of Japan, I guess. There were a few targets worth the trip that concerned the Navy, since most of the enemy had evacuated from the area, apparently unwilling to face our amphibious assault. So it was decided that our regiment would be moved up north and turned over to the 1st Red Banner Army. So we're back in the Army, no longer with the Navy. Two IL-10 squadrons of the 26th SHAP would be transferred to Pograniczny Airfield. Okay, I guess that's where we are. And be at the disposal of the local commanders for the remainder of the war. Okay, good. So we were out, of course, against Germany. We took care of them. We're taking care of the Imperial Army. Imperial Japanese Army with the Russian Navy. We took care of that. We are now assisting the Russian Army up north here. So someone's going here, and then on the west side of the map, someone else is doing, and we're doing the pincer movement. Try to choke down this point. And I'm going to be destroying something. That's what the Sturmovik do.